recess of the whole year! Yippee!
All right, children. Hurry back after recess. We have a spelling lesson right after recess.
But it's the last spelling lesson of the whole year! Yippee!
Oh, okay. Take it easy, but enjoy your recess. Steve, can I see you for a moment?
Yeah, sure, Mr. Puzzleman. What is it?
Didn't you miss school yesterday?
Don't worry, Mr. Puzzleman. I didn't miss it at all. Just kidding. Here's my excuse note, Mr. Puzzleman.
The boys made their way out to the yard to play the very last game of baseball before the school year ended. Most of the boys headed out to the baseball field with a bounce in their step. But Steve trudged along reluctantly. You see, Steve didn't really like baseball too much. He was more than happy to simply sit on the side and watch the others play.
Steve, we need you for the baseball game.
What? I don't like playing baseball.
I know that, but we need you for the game. Come on, Steve. Let's go, Steve.
Come on, Steve. We need you to play.
Oh, all right. What position should I take?
Take the outfield. But don't forget to give it back.
Ha, ha, ha. Very funny.
Steve made his way to the outfield. He walked to the deepest part of center field.
Is this far enough yet?
Steve, we can still see you.
Oh, so I guess it's not far enough yet. All right, I'll go a little further.
Steve walked even further, deeper into the outfield.
You know, no ball ever comes here. Actually, one time a ball came here, but it was a meatball and it was part of my lunch. Come to think of it, another time there was a different ball out here. It was a falafel ball. That was also part of my lunch. I don't know why they put me out here. Hey, can you guys see me?
See who?
That's what I mean, you can't even see me.
Steve, we can still hear you. Go further.
Further? But if I have to go further, when I come back to take my turn at bat, I'll be too late and I'll miss my chance.
Good.
They don't even want me to bat. Why did they even ask me to play?
Steve stood in the outfield, waiting. Maybe a ball would come that far out. And suddenly he heard shouting.
Hey, Steve, wake up! Ball's coming! Steve, look up!
Steve looked up, but he was momentarily blinded by the sun. He quickly picked up his mitt to block the sun from his eyes. Suddenly, he heard a thwack in the mitt, and he heard cheering from the boys. Opened his mitt and there it was. He couldn't believe his eyes. Then he held it up with a smile from ear to ear.
Okay, I finally caught a ball. I hereby retire from baseball for the rest of my life. Yippee!
Just then, they heard the bell ringing for the end of recess. The boys made their way back to the classroom, each one smiling wider than the next. This was one of the sweetest moments of the year for a child. The last day of school. But not just the last day of school, the last hour of the last day of school. The children made their way back into the classroom. The lesson seemed to drag on for hours, even though it was less than an hour. And when the kids heard that sweetest sound of all, the bell of the last period of the last day of the year, they jumped for joy.
Yippee! School is over!
Hey, isn't anyone gonna say goodbye to me?
Goodbye to me!
No, I mean say goodbye to me!
Oh, okay, goodbye to you. Goodbye, Mr. Puzzlement. Have a great summer, bye.
Steve headed straight home.
Okay, let me take the key out from under the rock. What a brilliant hiding place. No one would ever think of looking there. Okay, I'll let myself in. My mother won't be home anyway for a few hours. Let me head straight for the couch. Last summer, I managed to stay on the couch for 72 hours and 36 minutes without getting off the couch. My mother was very upset with me for doing that, but I said, Ma, you can't blame me. I haven't done anything. This summer, I'm going to try to get to 73 hours to break my record of being on the couch without getting up for 73 hours